Yep, there's that. Come on over here. Bust this open. There we go. And I'm through. So there's these two guys, and again, same concept, just swing my wooden sword until they fall over. Because early game enemies, not yet a threat. This bird's pretty cool, it lets you buy a red health potion, which is worth 8 hearts, as well as a jar's worth of a jar's worth of the oil for my lantern, which I really don't need either of. Come over here and grab this chest, which gives me another yellow rupee. Every rupees, good amount to have early game. You really don't start needing anything more than 100 or 200 until you start like getting into the very late game. Now what I could do is swing my sword and break each piece, or I could just do a spin, destroy the whole thing with the spin. So I bring the kid back, and the kid's not too happy about it. Just don't tell my dad. My son told me Talo disappeared into the woods and had not returned. I came as soon as I heard. But looks like you brought him home already. I apologize. Such a task should not fall to you. Alright. You're lucky, maybe you'll eat Princess Zelda. Word on Ranch. Hey, Echo. Get going, huh? How about we finish up early today, bud? Alright. So I'm gonna come over here, I'm gonna grab Epona, and I'm gonna wrangle these goats.
Hey.
So it already taught me the mechanic of wrangling goats. So now it stepped it up, and now it has a timer. And there's 20 of them. I thought there were 30 of them. I must have been mistaken. But twice as many as I had to wrangle last time. Nonetheless, there's ways to like get these in real fast, and it's just unbeknownst to me. The way their pathfinding works is they get close enough to the gate, they just jump in on their own. But up until that point, it's real complicated, like how to get these guys to move the way you want it to. It's just something that I was never able to cling on to. Okay, that's all of them but 3. And they are flying in the other direction. Where's the one? I'll grab him first. Then I'm going to try to grab the other two in one fell swoop. Well, this guy's adamant on going to meet his friends. Alright. Come on. No, the other way, please. Goat, please. Your horns are stupid. Why is it a ring? Alright, so that's 19. And here's the last one, right over here. This is very akin in my mind to the one mission in the original Jak and Daxter 1, where you have to wrangle up the handful of Yak Cows for a power cell. It's, in my mind, the same thing, but now with the horse involved. 45 seconds faster than usual. And I'm over, and I'm out. I'm just gonna skip this. Girl comes, takes my horse. Ugh. That's enough of that. So I'm gonna come over here, get Epona back from this girl. You guys always restocking the store. You gonna say Ilya? That's the girl's name. Yeah, let's go see Ilya together. So they want to borrow my wooden sword. You know what? Whatever. This kid tells me he wants to be a much more gentle being, no sword fighting, just horse riding. So now I gotta keep pursuing onward to get this horse back from Ilya. Now, she's gonna have the gate locked, but there's a shortcut right here. Kind of a secret path that'll get me where I need to go. And once I'm out of here, back my horse. So you prefer your master over me, huh, Epona? They're worried about your horse, Echo. Fortunately, it looks like the injury isn't too serious. You two could go on together. But Echo, can you at least promise me this? No matter what happens in your journey, don't try to do anything out of your league, please. Just come back home safely. Okay. What is this? Now,